In today's video, I'm gonna explain how you can get a really awesome weapon and a helmet. These weapons and helmet are really rare, and you can get them only from one NPC. That NPC is gonna also provide you with a side quest that you can complete. I'm gonna explain everything, because there are actually two different methods of how you can get these items. The weapon that you are seeing right now, the cannonball, or I don't know, the iron ball, and that helmet that you are seeing on my head right now. Again, these are really awesome weapons in my opinion, and that helmet looks really cool. There are two different methods of how you can get the items. First, I'm gonna explain the short version, and then I'm gonna explain you the proper version, which I'll advise you to take. That's why I will stay a lot of time to show you how you can get them properly. First things first, reach the Scenic Isle, and from this Liurnia Lake location, you have to reach an NPC named Raya. Talk with her, and she will say to you that it will you will have to bring her the necklace that she lost. Easy, very easy, because that necklace is really close. Talk with her, and after the dialogue, complete all the dialogue, accept everything, and after you'll complete all the dialogue, you have to just go into the in the north. I'm gonna explain where. Just follow me. We are here, and we are going straight to that castle. I think that is the Raya Liurnia Academy. Yeah, I think that is the location. But we're gonna find an NPC. And here the short story goes. If you just want the items, and if you don't want to complete any of this side quest, but I'll strongly recommend you to complete the side quest, you just have to defeat this guy. Just attack him, kill him, and get all the items, bell bearing, get everything. Or you just you can talk with him and say to him, give me the necklace, and then you can just buy it for 1000 runes. I will advise you to do that. After you'll do that, you can talk with him again to buy some of his merchants. It has some crab parts, something like that. Buy that, because that it's a part of the quest. Definitely want to buy that. It's a little bit aggressive, but again, you will want to buy that that part of the shrimp, of the crab, or what it has. Like I just did right here. Then it's very important to buy that part. Then next thing is to reach the Lyndell capital. If you don't know how to reach that, you will have to use the Grand Lift of Dectus, and you will need two medallions. I have those medallions on my channel if you don't know how to get them, but I'm gonna assume that most of you already know how to reach that the capital. And if you want to enter into the capital, you're gonna need two great runes. Those two great runes, you can get them from Godric and Renala or Radahn, or I don't know. Easiest thing to do is to get them from Godric and Radahn or Renala. In my opinion, the easiest fights. And we're gonna start from this side of Grace near the capital, and I'm gonna show you where it will be the next location where that NPC will be. And yes, in this quest, in this video, you're gonna see how you can complete the full quest of Bogard, because Bogard is the name of that merchant, that crab cook. Yeah, it's a cook, it's a chef, the crab chef. Now just follow me. I'm gonna show you the map from time to time so you don't get lost. It's near the capital. Now the next step is to talk with him, and you can buy again, just complete all the dialogue that it has. It will have a lot of dialogue. Complete that, and then buy from this NPC again some crab parts. Buy them both, because yeah, I think it's a part of the quest. You have to buy them both, and let's just continue. Now the next thing is to make your way to the capital. It's very easy to make your way, but you have to defeat that three sentinel, that knight that's staying in the front of the doors. Again, you have to have two great runes in order to reach the capital, to enter into the capital. And we're gonna start from the first site of Grace, Capital Rampart, and we're gonna start from this location, from the east Capital Rampart, from the east side. And we have to take a certain item that is very important in the quest. Without this item, you cannot do anything. And this is the... there are five of these, the Seedbed Curse. But this is the easiest thing to get one. If you already have the Seedbed Curse in your inventory, then you can skip this little part. But we're gonna get that item really fast. The item is gonna be here, and while we are here, you know what, if I want to make your life even easier, we have to continue the road from this location. Don't teleport anywhere, because we have to take two more site of Grace. Really easy to get, so just follow me, jump on this balcony, be careful and just follow my steps. Everything is on fast forward, but if you think it's too fast, you have the option to slow it down a little bit in on YouTube. But all you, don't fight those guys. All you want to do is to climb, to go down on these stairs. I died here once because that monster will come from nowhere, and you're gonna get the next sight of Grace. Then keep following me. This will be your next site of Grace, and now all you have to do is to reach the sewers. It's very important to reach that part of the sewers where we have to continue the quest. So again, keep following me. We're gonna continue from the West Capital Rampart. Here is gonna be a well hidden. That well is gonna be hidden, so just search right over here. You can go in daytime so we can see it better if you think it's something too dark. Then just open this door and make your way to the next site of Grace. After you will take the site of Grace, all you have to do is to rest here, because yes, you're gonna be follow maybe, and you want to go to the Round Table Hold. Now you can come in contact with the Dung Eater, which is a really important NPC. It will can change the ending of your game. So everything that I'm gonna show you right now, it's a part also the first part of the Dung Eater quest. So you're gonna shoot two rabbits with one stone. Really nice. Now complete all the dialogue, and with that Seedbed Curse, you're gonna get the key. It's very important. Again, this is the the long path of how you can get those items, because there is another one that you all you have to do is to kill that enemy, that not enemy, NPC. But again, I'm not recommend you to do that. Now just teleport to the site of grace that we just found, and here we're gonna find the dung eater, and you will have to tell him to leave the goal, and that's it. You're gonna use the key. Be very careful after you climb this ladder, because there will be a hand in the middle and you don't want to get trapped. You don't want to get jumped, actually. And after you're gonna talk with the dung eater, all you have to do is to go back to Bogart in the same location where you just meet him, near the capital, to that river or to that pound or whatever it is. So here all you have to do is to talk with him. If you didn't bought the crab parts, now it's time to buy them, and also complete all the dialogue, everything. And then you have to reload the game. If you don't know how to reload the game without exiting this place, just go to main menu, exit the game in the system, and re-enter into the game, and the menu will be reloaded. Easy as that. Or you can just go to another site of grace and be back here if that will not work. After you're gonna be back, your NPC will be injured, as you can see right now, and it will die. When it will die, you're gonna get all the items, and the side quest will be completed. Also the dung eater part, it will be just made the dung eater part perfect, because you go to all this dialogue with Bogart, which is a part of the dung eater quest. After you're gonna get his items, you're gonna get invaded by the dung eater, but that is for another quest. Now it's time for us to see the items. You're gonna get that seedbed curse. Also, you're gonna get the bell bearing of Bogart. You're gonna get the helmet and the weapons that you are seeing right now. Let me show you the stats. Let me show you how they work. They have a special skill, a special ability. This one, the roar. And these are the stats for the weapon. I already upgraded to level 24. The Bogart's Roar is the Braggart Roar is the special skill. The damage is not that high, but let me tell you something. They are so fast, and it seems like you are boxing now with your enemies. And the mask, it will be like this. Immunity, it's okay. It's pretty cool looking weapon, and a pretty cool looking helmet, in my opinion. Now let's see what this can do, this weapon can do, because the helmet, yeah, is just a cool item to have. Okay, boxing. If you like to box, here we go. And you got into all of this to get these two items. Probably it worth it, probably, I don't know. But definitely a cool quest, and thank you so much for watching. Like, subscribe, share, press the notification bell, and I'm gonna see you in the next one. Have a great day. Bye. Now it's time for me to box some soldiers.